Hello again. In this video, I will show you how to paint a hand. Well, actually not this one here, but this one here. So, stay tuned. I'm Toby. This channel here is all about showing you how to draw and paint. So, make sure you hit the subscribe button here not to miss any new episode. So, here we go now with the painting of the hand here, and I did not include the color mixing process here. I have a video about this, link is here somewhere here. Basically you see that I put on the colors side by side most of the time and start to blend them together. Already starting here to work in some little details already, like the wrinkles on the thumb. Putting on colors and working them in, reworking them, getting more shadows in, a bit less, and so on. Yes, here we start with the finger, and the light comes from above and bounces off from the middle finger, so we have to light up the right part of the finger, as you can see here, to make it really realistic looking. Starting with a bigger brush at the beginning and then going in with a smaller brush, but we are not yet quite there. I will, as you can see now, light it more up. And also here we have the color coming in from the left part of the painting, from behind the person. And we have to put that also in, these lighter colors on the thumb, for example. And you see, I go in with the smaller brushes and build up more or less the flesh tones here that need to be lightened up. And these brown spots here, you might wonder why they are in here in this painting. They are in because the person carries a dog on his hand, and the dog is mostly brown, and so we have to put in also these colors the dog to make this whole thing looking realistic. And that's the big advantage of working with oils. You can go over the whole process while the color's still wet, and it's much easier to get this thing done in oils than in acrylics. Yeah, put in all the wrinkles between the fingers. And you see these colors are differently. They darker, lighter. And working my way back and forth to get this thing looking really 3D and realistic. I'm putting in the shadows under the hand here, and as you see, now it looks like cut out, and to avoid this you need to blend those two colors together to get this a really realistic looking hand. And I think this is the key to painting realistic. You need to blend a lot. Transitions need to be soft and not so hard, so make sure we get them in. Yeah, now I'm putting in the shadow under the dog. And you see, not quite dark enough, so I go over it again. And you also see that I work pretty much the whole hand back and forth, adjusting colors, like here, like the shadows that have to be different, stronger and lighter. Yeah, working in all those details, those little fine lines and dots, and like here, these highlights here. Going in roughly at the beginning with a bigger brush. And then going in with a smaller brush to get these things like here a bit more fleshed out. And the details are the things that make the difference in a painting. If you will let them out, the painting will look flat and not really realistic. And although I know I'm not a hyper-realist, I want to achieve a pretty good realism in this painting here, in all of my paintings actually. Therefore I take my time to really work my way back and forth to really make sure this thing starts to look real. Not hyper-real, but real enough that you are convinced that this might be real. At least a little bit. And I see there's a lot of detail in this part here. And here now the highlights on the ring. And you see this makes also a really big difference. Looks much more realistic now with this strong highlight on the upper side. And this process of putting in details and reworking them and going over the whole painting again and again, this is really what makes the difference. So take your time and invest this time to really get this thing, yeah, looking realistic. So I think that's it now, and it came out pretty nice, I think.
So that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and please do like, share and subscribe, and see you next Friday or Sunday, hopefully. Bye!